In this video, we are going to solve example 6.13 that is taken from chapter number 6, Bending, and book name is Mechanics of Material by R.C. Hibbeler, 9th edition. So statement of the problem is the beam shown in figure 6-27A has a cross-sectional area in the shape of channel. In figure 6-27B, determine the maximum bending stress that occur in the beam at section AA. So you can see this is a cantilever beam that is having fixed support at this end, and the total length of the beam is 3 meters, and the load at this end on the left side is 2.6 kilonewton, that is inclined load. All the ratios are given, 12, 5 and 13. So this is the cross section of this beam at section AA or through any length. The cross section is shown over here. So you have to determine the maximum bending stress at section AA. So let's start with the solution. What will be the first step? Here we do not require the reaction force since we are finding the bending stresses at maximum bending stresses at section AA. For that, what we have to do is that we have to take the left hand side of the beam and draw the free body diagram, which I have drawn here in figure 6-27C. What will be the first step? The first step is that you can see this force is inclined. It is making an angle theta with horizontal. So it will have two components. One is along x-axis and another one will be along y-axis. Clear? So first we will find this, let this component is vertical component Fy and this is horizontal component Fx, and let this force is F. So now by using sine theta, so if you take sine theta will be equal to 12 divided by 13, that is the sine value. And what will be the cos theta? So cos theta will be equal to 5 divided by 13, base divided by hypotenuse. Now we know that if you take sine theta in term of fx and f, so this sine theta will be equal to fy divided by f, and from here you will get this fy will be equal to f sine of theta. Now put the value, so fy will be equal to f is 2.6 kilonewton and sine of theta is 12 by 13. So what we will get is that we will get this Fy will be equal to, how much we will get? Fy will be equal to 2.4 kilonewton. Okay, now this is the value of Fy. So we will calculate Fx by using cos theta is equal to Fx over Fy, base over hypotenuse, which is F, sorry. So from here we will get this Fx will be equal to F cos of theta. So F value is 2.6 and cos theta is here. You can see this is 5 by 13. So 5 by 13 will give you Fx. And when you calculate it, you will get this Fx will be equal to 1 kilonewton. We'll write this vertical force which we have calculated was 2.4 kilonewton and horizontal force was 1 kilonewton. And when you section it at section AA, so definitely you will be having a shear force, vertical shear force V, you will be having a normal force N, and you will be having moment M. And you can see since this cross section, this normal force will act at the centroid, so it is downward from this top surface, and we will calculate how much is the neutral axis lies in this section and where we have to apply this normal force. So for that we have to find the neutral axis. So finding, next step will be finding the neutral axis. What we will do, you can see the cross section, so we will mark it as 1, 1 because they both are same, and this is 2. Okay, so for finding the location of neutral axis, we have formula y bar is equal to sum of y into a divided by sum of the area, where if you expand it, so it will be equal to 2 times y1 into a1 plus y2 into a2 divided by sum of area, which is equal to 2 a1 plus a2. Now, what is y1? So I can write it. It will be y1. It will be dash. Okay. So what will be y1 dash? So y1 dash is distance from any reference line to the mid of that section. So let's take this line as a, let take this top line is a reference line. So from this top line, reference line, the mid of this section, you can see this is 200. So half of it will be equal to y1 dash. It will be y1 dash, and that will be equal to 100 millimeter. So I will write it 100 millimeter, and in meter it will be equal to 0.1 meter. What is the area A1? So A1, you can see here that this is the area, this is thickness 15 and this is height is 200 millimeter. So I, in term of meter, I can write it as 200 meter is 0.2 multiplied by thickness is 0.015. Okay. Now what about y2 dash? So y2 dash is distance from this reference line till the mid of that section. So this was reference line and this is the mid of that section 2. So this distance, you can see thickness is 20. So this y2 dash will be equal to 20 divided by 2, that is 10 millimeter. So in meter, it is equal to 0.01 meter. And what is area A2? So area A2, you can see the width is 250 millimeter and thickness is 20. So 250 millimeter is 0.250 multiplied by thickness is 0.02. And all unit will be in square meter. Now you have all the values, just plug it in this formula. Y dash bar is equal to 2 times y1 dash is 0.1 multiplied by area, which is 0.2 multiplied by 0.015, plus what is y2 dash? So y2 dash is 0.01 multiplied by area is 0.250 multiplied by 0.02 divided by sum of areas. So 2 times area A1, so 2 multiplied by area A1 is 0.2 multiplied by 0.015 plus area A2, which is 0.250 multiplied by 0.02. So if you solve that, so you will get y dash, that will comes out to be 0.05909 meter, or in term of millimeter, it will be equal to 59.09 millimeter. So this is the location of its neutral axis. It means that neutral axis is 59.09 millimeter down from the reference line, and it is already shown in this figure. You can see this is y bar, which is 59.09 millimeter. Now we will represent here in this diagram, free body diagram, that from this top surface, this neutral x, this normal force is acting at the neutral axis, and this distance is 0.05909 meter. Why? Because you can see that here, this normal load and this normal load, they are not lying in the same line, and there is a distance between these two. So what will happen? It will produce a moment or couple in this direction, and we will find it in a while. Now we will move toward finding this this moment m by using equation of equilibrium. So what will be the equation of equilibrium? That sum of all moment about point at section AA must be equal to zero, and taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. So about this section AA, one moment is this m, which is clockwise, that will be taken as negative. So I will write it minus m. The second load that is producing moment about this section A is 2.4 kilonewton load, and perpendicular distance is how much? This is producing, this is 2, okay. So, and this is producing counterclockwise moment, so it will be positive. So I will write plus 2.4 multiplied by 2. And the another moment that is produced by this normal load, or this is producing in counterclockwise. Okay, so this will be also positive. So from here you can see this is 1 kilonewton to the left side, and this is right n toward right side. It means that n will be also equal to 1 kilonewton. So we'll write plus 1 kilonewton into perpendicular distance is 0.05909 will give you their sum of all this moment about section AA must be equal to 0. So from here, what we will calculate? We will calculate this moment, resulting moment M, and this after calculation, you will get it 4.859 kilonewton into meter. Now you have this moment M at section AA. So what we are going to do is that we will find this bending stress, and we know that bending stress is equal to moment into C divided by I. Since we have this moment M, we do not have section property, second moment of inertia for this beam. So what we will do, we will calculate this M, which is section property. And you can see that neutral axis is this one, that is at a distance of 59.09 millimeter from the top. So it is not symmetrically about this neutral axis. So what we will use, that we will use parallel axis theorem in order to calculate this I. And what is the parallel axis theorem? That it is I dash is equal to I plus A D square. And if you, there are many members, so you can write sum of I plus A D square. Now moving toward finding this, since you can see we have two portion of one segment and another one is two. So what we will do is that we will write I is equal to, first what we will do is that we will calculate for the portion two. We will calculate I for this portion 2. And you can see its base is 250 millimeter and height is 20 millimeter. So I can write 1 over 12, base is 0.250 in meter and height is 0.02 whole cube. 1 over 12 BH cube. And you can see that this segment is away from this centroidal axis. So we will have this term AD square. What is the area? Area for is A2, which is 0.250 multiplied by 0.02. And what is D square? So D is distance from this neutral axis till the mid of this section. This is equal to D2. And this D2 can be obtained if you subtract 10 from this. The half of this is 10, this is 10, this portion is 10, clear? So 59.09 minus 10 will give you D square. So I can write it as that 59 in meter, I will write all the values in meter. So 0.05909 minus 10, which is 0.010 whole square. So this is the moment of inertia for second member. Now we'll find the moment of inertia for the first one. Also, you can see the first one having base is 15 millimeter and height is 200 millimeter. So I can write 1 over 12 multiply by base is 0.015 and height is 200, which is 0.2 cube plus area of A1, which is 0.2 multiplied by 0.015. And what is D square for that? So D is distance from neutral axis till the mid of first section. So this is the mid of the first section. So you can see that mid is at a distance of, this is at a distance of 100 from this top. This is 100 millimeter. So 100 millimeter minus 59.09. So I, in meter, I can write it as 0.100 minus 0.05909 whole square. And we will multiply it with 2. Why? Because you can see we have two members of portion 1. So this is the two portion. These are the two portion. Okay. Now when you calculate all this by using your calculator, so you will get the moment of inertia that comes out to be 42.26 into 10 raised to power minus 6, and unit will be meter power 4 because we have converted all units into meter. Now we have this I as well. So what will be the value of C. So C is distance from neutral axis till top or bottom, and since we have been asked to find the maximum bending stress, so you can see from this neutral axis, this distance is maximum, clear? The above one is also C, you can take as C, but this is the maximum value of C which will give you the maximum bending stress. So how you will find this C? So total height is 200 minus 59.09 will give you this C. So I will write it here, 200 millimeter. So 200 millimeter is 0.200 minus y dash is 0.05909, and when you calculate it, you will get 0.1409 meter. Now you have all the values, just plug it in this formula, that maximum bending stress will be equal to m into c divided by I. So you can put the value, what is moment, so that is equal to 4.859 multiply by 10 to the power 3, unit will be now newton into meter, and what is c? C is 0.1409, unit will be meter, divided by I, which is 42.26 into 10 to the power minus 6. I will write the unit newton into meter for moment, meter for the C, divided by meter power 4 for I. Okay, that will give you maximum bending stress. So when you calculate this maximum bending stress, this comes out to be 16.2 into 10 to the power 6 newton per square meter, and that will give you 16.2 mega, and newton per meter square is pascal. So 16.2 mega pascal, which is the answer of our this question. Now if you want to find this stress at the top, so what will be the C value? So C is then C will be equal to 59.09. so we will put it, we will do this extra, some extra work. So sigma at the top will be equal to m into c divided by I. So moment is 44.859 into 10 to the power 3 multiplied by c was 0.05909 divided by I, which is equal to 42.26 into 10 to the power minus 6. That will give you sigma at the top. Okay, so when you solve this, you will get the answer will be 6.79 megapascal. So in this way, you have calculated, you have to calculate the stresses both at the top and bottom, but the maximum stress is at the bottom, which is 16.2 megapascal at section AA. And that was all about this example 6.13 that is requested by one of the subscribers to explain it. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.